So now we have a working demo of backing up. It's backing up our database. It's also backing up our file system. Now, of course, you can configure those to just back up your database or just back up your file system. But right now, I want to back up both. I think that's fine. And I want to show you scheduling. So scheduling, you don't have to go and make an artisan command or a command console. It already has one set up for you. So all you do is go into your scheduler and just add the lines that you need. I'm going to just copy this one and I'm going to go and show you that. So app, commands, and then inside that I have a generate sitemap command. I have also the kernel now. Then under schedule, I have the previous one that I did for another demonstration, which was generating a sitemap. I'll now do a schedule command backup daily. Sometimes I like to do this format, and you might be doing the same. I kind of try to line up these arrows. So this makes the line length not as long, and it's just easier to read, kind of just stacks down. But it's up to you on how you want to sort of chain and structure those commands. So schedule command backup colon clean daily at 1. Well, what's that going to do? Well, that's going to remove, depends on your configuration, but any backups that you no longer need. You also have backup run, which an hour later, according to this, is actually going to run that backup. So if we change this to backup run, that's going to actually run. So you can set these up inside your scheduler. Notice this one's weekly, this is daily, and then at a specific time. There's a bunch of different configuration that you can do to set that up at what time you want to run that at. To see those configurations, just do a simple Laravel kernel scheduler. So Laravel kernel scheduler, and or just go to laravel.com and type that inside this search here. This is the task scheduler. You'll find this in Digging Deeper under Task Scheduler. And it shows you the basics. You could probably skip through a lot of this and jump down into this zone here. So these are all these nice methods. Now, if you're very comfortable with the old method of the cron or that default method, which I assume you're probably not because you're watching this series and you're just looking for some basics getting started with backing up and the cron, then that's how it was set up before. And that format's a little bit complicated. As you see these asterisks like this, you would put numbers there to specify which one's hours and days and minutes. I can never figure it out. Well, I guess I can figure it out. I sometimes go in and do like a generator and then it goes and generates the things because I can't remember which one's which. It's one of those things that I just always have to look up. Luckily, Laravel's made this very, very easy. So instead of writing a format like this, and at first glance, you won't even know what it's doing necessarily or when it's going to run, you can do it in easy readable words. So every minute's gonna run, every 5 minutes it's gonna run. You could say daily at a specific time, twice daily, weekly, monthly. You also have these methods down here, weekdays, Sundays, Mondays. And of course you can chain these together or you can run multiple commands if you want to. So you get exactly the right time that you wanna run that command and it's configured and it'll run. So pretty awesome. I'm pretty good with daily at 1. Now keep in mind, this is also gonna relate to your time zone. So the time zone that you have your Laravel app configured with is gonna be the time zone that it's gonna run at based on that cron. So if you didn't set that time zone correctly, then you're gonna run into issues. When I'm talking about that time zone, it would be nice, I think, if they added that to the ENV file for time zone. But as of right now, it's not in there. To change that, if you go to your app URL and you scroll down to time zone, you can see the time zone and specify it. Now, I guess it's not in the ENV file because you probably are not switching your time zone around that often. But if you needed to change it, that's where you would want to go and change it. So it's UTC right now, maybe your Pacific time, or you want to run it as like America / Los Angeles or something like that. Depends on where you're coming from, what time zone you need to set it up with. That way those numbers match up with when you're running your kernel or your cron to make sure it's running exactly the time that you say it's supposed to run at. So that's setting up the kernel and the cron commands. The next thing I want to move to is configuring some of the email that might be involved with it and some miscellaneous tasks. Then we're going to move on to actually setting this up with an S3 instance on Amazon. and show you what's involved to configure that.